It's Birth and Death Awareness Month, and the Birth and Death Registry is, you know, embarking on some education all throughout the year. In fact, all throughout this month, and they plan to extend it all through the year. But, you know, our main issues have been that when we go to try and register, it takes so long. It takes so long. And the reason is that there are a lot of Goro boys there, the middlemen who, you know, go around the system and then also clog the system in return. So we'll be speaking to the acting registrar for Births and Deaths Registry, Reverend Kingsley Asare Addo, this morning. You're welcome.
Thank you.
He'll be helping us understand how we can actually register, go through the registration process smoothly. So, Reverend Kingsley, you're welcome once again.
Thank you once again. Let me quickly just say that we need to demystify all the mystics around birth registration.
Okay.
The truth is that birth registration is supposed to be done at birth and not later in life.
Okay.
So, our focus will be trying to reach children as soon as they are born.
Mm.
Once we did it, then there will be no need for anybody growing up to come and queue for
that.
A birth registration. Let us get the Goro boys out of business.
Out of business.
By ensuring that as parents, as soon as we give birth, we name the child, and within a space of 1 year, the law requires that we register the child, and it's for free.
So I would have to come, as a parent, I would have to come to your registry to get that done, right?
Yeah. Our registers are actually cited, especially in all the public
hospitals.
Yeah. Police hospital.
Yeah.
Our problem is a bit in the rural areas,
okay.
But we are tackling that as well.
Okay.
So we would wish that if Ghanaian parents went to deliver, you would have decided on the name even before the child is born. Today you can determine the sex of a child.
Yeah.
So let's say if it's a male, I call him Kofi Bensa.
Mm.
Right at Kolibu Hospital,
yeah.
We have an office sitting there.
Okay.
Just pass through, get the event registered, and within 10 minutes, you have your birth certificate. If we did that for all children, then we are not adding on to the backlog of adults who don't have a registration. They are clogging the system.
Okay.
Because they have deadlines.
Mm.
I need to get a passport tomorrow.
Yes,
I need
indeed.
To attend an interview tomorrow. So then he has a deadline and he's come to put pressure on everybody.
Okay.
They divert attention from the few staff who are supposed to service the whole population.
Okay.
And we are focusing on adult registration, which actually does not add anything to our coverage measures.
Okay. So if... walk us through the process. You know, if I don't register my baby at birth, how do I get registered? Walk us through the process.
I rather want us to see what you do to register a baby at birth.
Okay.
And then we look at if you don't register. If you have a child,
mm-hmm.
you are giving some evidence that a child has been born, and the evidence comes in the form of a weighing card.
Mm.
So all you need to do is to present the weighing card to the nearest registration office.
Okay.
And then within 10 minutes, we take you through a questionnaire. We take details about the child, name, date of birth, place of birth. Then we take details about the parents, father, mother, and all that. Once we capture that and it's lodged in a birth register, within 10 minutes, we issue a birth certificate and give to you. And let me be quick to say that when we talk about the birth certificate, there's also the erroneous impression that this is not a birth certificate. This people are nicknaming.
Please hold it up.
Can a temporary certificate. If you are saying this is temporary, this is it's not international. But I want to say that we have only one birth certificate in this country.
Only one birth certificate?
Only one birth certificate. And that is what you are holding.
So this is the official
birth certificate.
Of Ghana?
Of Ghana.
Okay.
And it's issued for every child who is registered before age one for free. And it's
before
valid.
Before age one for free?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's valid for life.
Okay.
Now, the misconception is about the certified true copy, which travel documentation purposes will require that people produce.
Yeah.
And that is this type.
Oh,
and
people
are nicknaming this one biometric birth certificate, international birth certificate, and there's nothing biometric about this document.
So this is what's the
certified copy, which means that if an event has been registered and a certificate is issued, and for one reason or the other, you misplace your birth certificate or you can't find it, then you apply for a certified copy.
Okay.
So we now query our existing records, pull your data out, and print it out on this one for you, and put a seal on it that this event has been registered.
Okay.
We have it in our records, so legally, we are giving you this as a certified
copy. And how long does it take me to get this?
If you are registered already, it should take you a week.
A week?
Between 3 to 5 days to
get
this.
Why so long, though? If it's just about a matter of pulling out documents and printing?
It depends on the period in which you're registered. If you're registered after 2009, that data is in our database already.
Okay.
So then we query our system and we can generate for you. Okay. If I say before 2009, we have a backlog of records sitting dating back to 1912, and these are in volumes of books. So we will need to do a manual search, extract your information, and then feed it into the system to get your certified copy out for you. But we are trying to capture all that backlog of data into digital format.
Okay.
So in the next year, I'm sure we'll have all our data sitting in a database. Okay. Then once you come, you mention your name, your date of birth, within a question of, say, 1 or 2 days, we should be able to give you a certified copy.
You said next year. We'll hold you to that.
Yes.
You also have an online portal, but is it actually functioning? Because I tried some time ago and
we have had to suspend it because we are now loading all the data into the central, the digital format.
Okay.
So once we finish with the upload, we will now activate all the online portals and all these things. But my main issue here is that if we register all children as soon as they are born, no adult will come and say, I was not registered. Because that is the avenue, the window through which most foreigners are passing to beat the system. Somebody walks to our office and says, I'm a Nigerian. He doesn't speak Nigerian. He says, he mentions a name which you know is clearly a foreign name. And then he says, I was born in Tudu. Bring evidence. He says, I can't bring it. Flats have taken my way in car. And there's no way to testify. And yet he insists he was born in this country. So how do we ascertain the truth about what he's saying? It will take time for us to go around and do some checks. And these are people who now come and say, it is taking too long. It is taking too long for me to get the birth certificate. But you've waited for 40 years and nothing happened to you. If you waited for 3 weeks, I don't think you will.
So
we want to discourage late registration.
Late registration.
And focus on infant registration.
Okay. All right. So late, we should stop late registration and focus on infant registration.
That is my wish.
Yes. And then the adults who don't have one, they should come to your office and you source them out.
They should go to the nearest registration office. And in fact, let me add that every birth by the law is supposed to be captured in the district where the event occurred.
Okay.
So if you reported your birth in Accra and you were born in KJB, we could take your information, but we have to relay that to our KJB district office.
Okay.
They will do the registration. Okay. Send it back to us and then we can give you a date for collection.
Okay.
But people come in, they are impatient.
Okay.
So you ask him to wait and he expects that you get an instant certificate. When he himself has waited for 40 years and didn't register.
He's still stressing on this. All right. Thank you so much for the education. That's the Acting Registrar of Birth and Death Registry, Reverend Kingsley Asare Ado. Thank you so much for the information.